Hello friends. So in the subject of business analytics, today we will discuss the topic business performance management. First of all, the overview or concept of business performance management. In the business and trade literature, a business performance management has a number of names like corporate performance management, enterprise performance management, and strategic enterprise management. The term business performance management refers to the business processes, methodologies, metrics, and technologies used by enterprises to measure, monitor, and manage business performance. It encompasses three key components. First, a set of integrated closed loop. Closed loop means an automatic control system in which an operation, process, or mechanism is regulated by feedback. So, a set of integrated closed loop management, an analytic process which is supported by technology that addresses financial as well as operational activity. Second, tools for business to define strategic goals and then measure and manage performance against those goals. Third, a core set of processes including financial and operational planning, consolidation means merging, and reporting, modeling, analysis, and monitoring of key performance indicators which link to organizational strategy. So this is all about business performance management. Let's try to understand the concept of business performance management cycle. As you can see on your screen, the chart shows the cycle of business performance management. Indicates strategies, plan, monitor, and analyze, and act and adjust. So in strategies, we can see mission, values, goals, objectives, incentives, strategy maps. In plan, we can see budgets, plans, forecasts, models, initiatives, and targets. In monitor and analyze, we can see performance dashboards, reports, analytical tools, and in last one, act or adjust, interpret, collaborate, assess, decide, act, adjust, and track. And these all four things are interconnected with integrated data and metrics. So let's see one by one. First, strategize. Here we have to answer the question, where do we want to go? Here in strategy, in a business setting strategy, setting a strategy is the art and the science of crafting decisions that help business achieve their goals. It is the process of identifying and stating the organization's mission, vision, and objectives, developing plans, means different level for strategic, tactical, and operation to achieve these objectives. And last one, business strategy provides an overall direction to the enterprise and is the first and foremost important process in the business process management methodology. Second one, plan. Here we have to answer the question, how do we get there? When operational managers know and understand the what means organizational objectives and goal, so they will be able to come up with the answer how. So first of all, they have to understand about what, and they will get the answer of how, means detailed operation plan or financial plan. So an operational plan translates an organization's strategic objectives and goals into a set of well-defined tactics and initiatives, resource requirements, and expected results for some future time period. The financial planning and budgeting process has a logical structure that typically starts with those tactics that generate some form of revenue or income. Next, third one, monitor or analyze. Here we have to answer the question, how are we doing? When the operational and financial plans are underway, it is imperative that the performance of the organization be monitored. A comprehensive framework for monitoring performance should address two key issues, what to monitor and how to monitor. After the organization has identified the indicators or measures to look at, it needs to develop a strategy for monitoring those factors and responding effectively. These measures are often called key performance indicators. Next. Number four, act or adjust. Here we have to answer the question, what do we need to do differently? Here, whether a company is interested in growing its business or simply improving its operations virtually, all strategies depends on new projects, means creating new products, entering into new markets, acquiring new customers or business, or streamlining some processes. So most companies approach these new projects with a spirit of positivity rather than objectivity, ignoring the fact that the most new projects and ventures fail. What is the chance of failure? Obviously, depends on the type of project. So next one is a key performance indicator. So key performance indicators, also known as KPIs, are measurable values that show you how effective you are at achieving business objectives. For example, one retail store might want to enhance the customer experience, so they would choose key performance indicators like customer satisfaction and customer retention. According to one definition given by Eckerson, KPIs are multidimensional. So this means KPI has a variety of different factors. So let's see one by one. First of all, strategy. It means KPI represent a strategic objective. Second, target. KPI means a measure performance against specific targets. Targets are defined in strategy, planning or budget session and can take different forms. For example, achievement targets, reduction targets, etc. Next, ranges. Targets have performance ranges. For example, above, on or below target. Next, encoding. Ranges are encoded in software enabling the visual display of performance. For example, green, yellow or red. So encoding can be based on percentage or more complex rules. The next one is the time frames. The targets are assigned time frames by which they must be accomplished. A time frame is often divided into smaller intervals to provide a performance milepost. And the last one is a benchmark. So targets are measured against the baseline or benchmark. The previous year's results often serve as a benchmark, but arbitrary numbers or external benchmark are also be used. So some of the examples of KPI. So sales related example. So example of sales KPIs are number of new contracts signed per period, dollar value or any other currency value for new contract signed per period about the with the customer, number of engaged qualified leads in sales process, hours of resources spent on sales follow-up, average time for conversion, and net sales or dollar or any other currency or percentage growth. Next, examples of financial KPIs like growth in revenue, net profit margin, gross profit margin, operational cash flow, current accounts receivables, inventory turnover, and EBITDA, means earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortizations. So these are the KPIs of finance. Next one, example of marketing KPIs. First, monthly website traffic, number of qualified leads, then conversion rate for call to action content, then keywords in top 10 search engine results, then blog articles published this month, and ebooks published this month. So these all are the examples of key performance indicators. So next one is a dashboard. So dashboards provide a visual display of important information that is consolidated and arranged on a single screen so that the information can be digested at a single glance and easily drilled in and further explored. So dashboards are used in a wide variety of business for a wide variety of reasons. So according to one definition given by Eckerson, he's a well-known expert on BI and in general. So for business intelligence and in general concept, dashboards in particular, the most distinctive feature of a dashboard is its three layers of information, which are three layers: monitoring, analysis, and management. Monitoring means graphical, abstracted data to monitor and key performance metrics. Analysis, summarize dimensional data to analyze the root cause of problem. And the last one is management. It's detailed operational data that identify what actions to take to resolve a problem. In dashboard, further we will discuss. All well-designed dashboards and other information visualization possess the following characteristics. Like, first, they use visual components to highlight at a glance the data and exceptions that require actions. So visual components like charts, bars, meters, spotlights, etc. Second, they are transparent to the user, meaning that they require minimal training and are extremely easy to use. Third one, they combine data from a variety of systems into a single summarized unified view of the business. And next one, they present a dynamic real world view with timely data refreshes, enabling the end user to stay up to date with any recent changes in the business. And the last one, they require a little, if any, customized coding to implement, deploy, and maintain. So there is a example of dashboard that you can see on your screen. So it is an example of a patient satisfaction dashboard. So dashboard is looks like this. Okay. So all the indicators and metrics are given here. KPIs are given here. So one can have idea about the what is going on about their activities. And these are the references that I have taken for making this video. So thank you very much for watching this video, and stay tuned for more such videos regarding business analytics and other subjects of management. Thank you very much.